Does your organization have poor communication between departments? Do members of your team say, "I didn't know about that," or "no one told me"? Do you realize how much this lack of communication is costing your business? Studies show that companies are losing millions per year because of inadequate communication to and between employees. A recent SHRM article about the cost of poor communication shares that 400 companies surveyed with 100,000 employees each cited an average loss per company of $62.4 million per year because of inadequate communications to and between employees. Another article mentions that miscommunication costs with smaller companies of 100 employees are on average of $420,000 per year. Now, in knowing this, why are we not training our employees on how to improve communication skills? In this video, I will share with you three simple tips that you can start practicing immediately and share with your team to improve communication. See how these simple tips will help improve communication and relationships in and outside of work. My name is Danielle Peters, the Director of Fun at The Training Store, and we help organizations with training programs that inspire teams to choose their attitude and be more engaged, which results in cohesive teams, passion-filled workplaces, and improved productivity. Tip number one, set aside distractions. Listening is more than using your ears. That's just hearing. We need to actually be fully present when someone is talking with you. Set aside distractions and truly listen. That means do not look at your phone or try to multitask while someone is communicating with you, whether this is over the phone or in person. If you are talking in person, provide direct eye contact and nod along with them to show you are understanding. Ask clarifying questions to the person talking and summarize what you hear. Tip number two, be aware. It's important to be aware of how you express yourself, either in person or over the phone. Your tone and body language can have a huge impact on how your communication is received from others. Try smiling while talking on the phone to lift your energy and to demonstrate that you care. People can hear it in your voice. If you are upset or speaking abruptly, this could lead to confusion with your message, as it could be misinterpreted. And if you are having a difficult day and feeling frustrated, it might be best just to reschedule that meeting or conversation so it does not impact your relationship or the result. Being aware of your attitude is essential when communicating and building relationships. Tip number three, appreciate and value. When people complain they're not being listened to, they're saying, "I don't feel valued." You can appreciate and value someone's opinion, even if it differs from your own. It's about showing respect and not rushing to judgment. Instead, ask more questions to learn how they came up with this information or suggestion. You can still recognize someone for making suggestions and offering solutions and thank them for participating. People want to be heard and contribute. There is a saying I love when employees say, "They hired my hands, but they could have had my brain for free." Publicly thanking people for offering suggestions and for getting involved. Listen with your heart, not just your head. Now, hopefully you found these three tips helpful. Fish philosophy is a way of being, and once adopted, it improves relationships both at work and home. We've only scratched the surface. I have so much to share with you. I would love for you to learn more about it and how you can share the world-famous training across your organization. So click the link below to find out more about our upcoming event on the Gold Coast. Happy fishing!